I risked my life for this shot. There are cane rats that big in there.
It's been almost 3 decades since I spent a decent amount of time on the Kwa Zulu Natal south coast. I have fond memories of this little town not far from Port Shepstone called Umzumbe. My aunt had a home there and I used to spend a lot of my youth playing on the beach, fishing, and I have fond memories of this little village. Little did I know that not far from Umzumbe, deep in the sugarcane fields, was a family at the forefront of surfboard and fin making. This family is the Maisch family.
You know when you start to question, like, where on earth am I going? Where am I going to end up? Am I going to be alive when I get there? Well, this is what it's kind of like going to the Maisch Brothers. What's you shaping there?
It's an egg flow. Takahama egg flow.
What?
Garth wants to flow with this. Flow with
it. Beautiful. How long have you been shaping now, Gary?
I started when I was 13 in school.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, I've just progressed.
Did you go to Sheppy?
Yeah, I went to Sheppy, yeah.
Okay, cool.
And then made boards for guys at school.
Yes. First.
Did everything. Shaping, spraying, glassing, sanding. And then I carried on shaping and worked for all different factories and ended up back here.
But you don't want to give away your age?
No, I'm 52. I mean, that's what I told you, I'm 25.
So you've been shaping close on what, 30 odd years, eh?
Yeah. 30 years, that's right, yeah.
Yeah,
look,
that's life is in Durban, growing up and walking that beach and. You know, Wedge was, all over the place.
Yeah, I know. I mean, look, we don't make a lot of boards, but, we still basically, we haven't gone to the new tech of CNC machines and that yet. I have got them on CNC, but I prefer doing, I find it more rewarding hand shaping, I think. And, machines are good for production. If you want a full production factory going, machine's the way to go.
Yeah.
I just prefer shaping by hand now. You know, I don't know, I've always enjoyed it. Probably the ultimate is to have both. And then you can have like a production line and then you have your custom hand shape, you know, ones. But
there's a saying, don't fix something that ain't broke.
Yeah.
So, and what do you think of all this, all the new shapes, the return to retro, like what is your view on it?
Well, look, basically boards have, the shapes of boards have like really in the last 10 years, people are open to new designs.
Mm.
So like beforehand it was that 6 foot, 18 and a half, 2 1/4 little toothpick, you know? But now, so people are more open now to different designs and that. And so it's always going to be this big circle going back to twin fins, single fins, retro shapes. And all the guys are doing just having fun, you know. And the older shapes are probably catching waves easier. You can have, you know, it's a different feel.
Mm.
You know. So it's all good. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. It's actually nice.
Yeah.
You know, and then you can have a quiver board. You know, instead of replacing that 6 foot board, you can have 5 boards, you know, you can have your fish, you can have your retro egg, you can have your whatever, you can have your high performance.
As long as they're all wedges.
No.
I'm giving you a punt there, bro.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's, so on the design wise, it's lacquer for a shaper. It's nice because you're not shaping the same thing all the time. So you've got to, you know, it's good. You know, put more fun into it and learn a bit more about the old shapes and things like that. You know, I like to put a little bit of a spin on it, put more modern contours, I suppose. Just get better flow. Yeah, that's Aka. That's all Aka. This is the first guy to travel around the world on a bicycle.
Really?
Not the first, but I did 24 countries, six continents.
Yeah.
I was the first fan to cycle between all the Super Rugby teams.
New
Zealand, Australia and South Africa.
Yeah.
Wow, really?
I did that, super fan.
Well, you kept that under your hat now, didn't you? Gary, I should be interviewing him.
No, it's cool. No, but he's stuck.
And I love surfing as well and love these EPS foam boards.
Yeah.
That was my first one I had.
Okay.
And I just like them, you know?
Yeah.
Compared to the polyurethane blanks. I like these EPS with the epoxy resin, especially for the fun boards.
Mm. Lekker.
3 to 5 foot waves, they go the best, I say. Definitely.
Gary, thanks for your time, dude.
No problem.
Really appreciate it.
Okay,
and may you keep doing what you're doing.
We'll try.
Can't wait to come back to the farm one day.
Yeah, no problem, dude. My pleasure.
Lekker, bro. Enjoy your new board, bro.
Thanks.
Keep surfing, keep cycling, keep fit. Thanks, guys.
Thanks. Lekker.
Me over now.
Speeding. Cool. Here we are at the infamous Maisch farm to speak to none other than Justin Maisch.
Yeah, look, Justin, this is quite an incredible place that you've got here. I must say, I'm like totally blown away with what I've seen with just driving in here. It's like, where on earth are we going? It's like driving into some sort of a paradise setting. You're locked away, you're in the bush. It's a secret location. Don't worry, we're not gonna tell anyone where the Maisch farm is. It's by special invite only, right?
Yeah.
Special invite, special handshake, all the rest. So sorry guys, this is a secretive one. Justin, tell us about Justin Maisch. We're in the south coast of Natal, Umzumbe. The floor is yours. Tell us all about you.
Ah, lekker. So I've been brought up in a surfing family. My oldest brother is like, was a pro surfer as well. My dad started shaping when he was younger and then he just taught us all to get into it, just roped us in. We all just got busy into it and life just went by and we spent our life on the beach surfing, making surfboards, having fun, competing, just like, yeah, the surfing lifestyle.
Living the dream,
some call it, yeah.
Awesome. So you've been on the south coast for all your life now, eh?
Basically, yeah, my whole life. Like, yeah, I moved to this premises when I was a couple months old. So.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah, look, I mean, what your family have done here is, like, this is, you can't get any more core south coast than this. This is like, and, you know, growing up as a kid, we would all see the famous Maisch logo on the, you know, back in the day when windsurfers were the in thing.
Yeah.
It would be on Midmar Dam and, like, Oaks would pull out their windsurfers and there the Maisch fins were.
Yeah.
And Max Ski, when paddle skiing was in, the Maisch fins were there.
Yeah.
So growing up as a Lati in Durban and South Africa, Maisch is synonymous on the lips of any waterman, basically.
Yeah. Any water sports, they're going to need fins and my dad just pulled the gap and made fins for any water sport available, really.
Amazing.
Basically. And he started in the 60s and
amazing.
It's still going today. So this started this factory in the mid-70s and it's still going today, which is a great thing.
Yeah, and cool. your father, is he still alive?
Yeah, he passed on in 2010.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, that's cool.
Wow. Yeah, that's an amazing thing, gift that he's taught you and given you, eh?
Yeah, family business. So we, Gary and myself, we just stuck into it, just continued, didn't stray off.
Yeah,
the lifestyle, like you say, yeah.
So that's it.
It's cool.
You must know this break here at Umzumbe like the back of your hand.
Yeah, Ooh. I probably know it better than all the other breaks around here.
Yeah. Yeah, this morning we were down on the beach and Justin was there first thing with his, you had a bit of a little surf camp there, huh?
Yeah, surf camp, surf lessons. Yeah, took some girls out there today.
Lovely.
We got ragdolled a bit, but it's good.
Good stuff. And Dad passed on the baton, and he taught you the skills of making fins, and that's what you do. That's your forte.
Yeah. Well, the whole workshop works as one, basically. You know, and we've kind of been through the whole process of every job in the factory, so
amazing.
We kind of know exactly how to do every job. Yeah. And I'm just managing that section at the moment.
And glassing is key, right?
Yeah.
Glassing is like, it's an integral part of that board.
Yeah. Did a lot of laminations. I've trained a young Chris up now. He's taking over from me from the glassing. He's doing really well. And it's like, yeah, it's good. The whole process. If you work in a factory, you got to go through the whole line.
Yeah.
That's the way it works there.
And how have you seen have you seen the South Coast change over the last 2 decades as you've grown up here? Have you seen a lot of changes, a lot of people moving in, a lot of young groms growing up, getting better at surfing, going on to bigger things?
Yeah, we're in the bottom end of the South Coast, so it's pretty undeveloped at the moment, but it has grown. Mm-hmm. Yes, it has, like over 20 years. It's probably doubled, you know. But it's like if you go further south by St. Mark's area, and that place is just tenfold, you know. New people, new families, new buildings. This little piece of coast that we live on, yeah, it's pretty untouched. We've got farmlands that are 300 meters from the beach. Mm-hmm. It's like, it's still pretty rural, basically.
Yeah, well, coming in here, it was pretty like an adventure. So, yeah, you don't have to say that twice. And long may that be, I think.
It seems to be staying like that for quite a while. I mean, I suppose it's whatever industry gets developed in the area, then that's going to help grow the industry, or grow the families and the schools and the hospitals. And
yeah, I suppose that is the positive knock-on effect, and that it provides more income for families.
True. Like I say, the industry we're in, like a lot of other old surfing shapers and that, we hands-on make the product from scratch. So it's like, when you do that, you're not making masses.
Mm.
So the demand and supply is a big thing, where people want a fin, they want it now, they don't want it 2 weeks' time.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
They've got a board, they've bought a board, they need a fin.
Yeah. We've always had some good team riders. I mean, Stevie Sawyer, and he won the world champs. Royden Bryson, he rides our boards and fins now. Greg Emsley, we sponsored him when he was on tour.
Doing a little project with Ricky at the moment, Bazza.
Yeah, he's sent him a funky pair of fins a few weeks ago, but he hasn't given me feedback yet.
Well, the thing is, here it is. We've collabed on a board with him, and he's going to be meeting his new sled this weekend.
Good.
So I think he's been waiting for this beast to stick those fins in. But he did kind of show me some sketches of those crazy fins that he's developed with you guys. They look wild.
Yeah, it's just a new, I wouldn't say era, but a new idea in surfing. It's been around. A lot of people have tried it around the world.
Mm-hmm.
And like, we're only getting into it, and it's doing wonders for all the guys on the coast here. They're really enjoying them.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, there we go, hey? The legacy continues. The Maisch legacy continues. So all we can say is support local. Right? Yeah, there's that buzzword going around. Support local. Well, local, put your money where your mouth is. And buy local fins. Don't buy fins from across the sea, because there's carbon footprint coming out of the jets. And if we're so earth conscious as surfers and people who like dig South Africa and whatever, buy Maisch fins, right? Because that's supporting local.
Nice, yeah. Oh, local's lekker.
Local's lekker. And can't wait to surf Umzumbe later today or tomorrow.
Yeah,
see awesome. You out there.
Yeah.
And thanks cool, for your man. Time, bro. I really appreciate it.
No problem.
Letting us into your lair.
Anytime.
This is the engine room. It's like how an engine room should look. Dirty and busy.
Yeah.
Okay? If it's clean, and then you know it's there's not enough work going around. Cheers, bro. Really cool. Appreciate your time, mate. Lekker.
Pleasure, mate.
That's it.
Good.